here's another segment of Crockpot Crack.
Love the Crockpot Crack.
This week, it has absolutely nothing to do with Crockpots.
But this stuff is awesome. So it sort of has something to do with crack.
So much like crack. So, quick synopsis of this little recipe here is, one day at work, a coworker came home from some vacation.
Mexico, I thought you said.
Yeah, I think it was Mexico. Came home and said, here, try this. And I said, what is it? She said, spicy pretzels. And I said, oh, okay, don't have to tell me twice. So I tasted it. I said, oh, wow, those are really good. What's in this? She said, I have no idea. So I sat there for the next hour just like, I taste lemon pepper. There's definitely cayenne. This is ranch. Anyhow,
you get that from your grandmother, by the way.
Yeah, I sure do. So I tasted it, I tasted it, and I thought I had it down. The only thing I was missing was garlic powder. Anyhow, so then I ended up looking up a recipe, finding a recipe, and realizing the only thing I was missing was garlic powder. And so now I make this recipe all the time. It's delicious. It's amazing. I introduced it to Dad. He found a little tweak that I actually like better, and that's what we're about to show you. So these are spicy pretzels, or as they're called online, spicy ranch pretzels, and today we're going to be making them with some of the mini or regular sized pretzel twists. We're using Snyder's today. And then the other ingredients, it's real super.
We allowed to show that?
Yeah.
We don't have to turn around.
Okay. But really super easy and cheap little snack. The only thing I will tell you is we found that it's better if you let it sit for a couple days.
Much better.
A few days, 3 days at least. 3 to 4 days, and it's better. The recipe online says, oh, just let it sit for an hour or two. I'm here to tell you, you can, but it's not as good. So our ingredients are a teaspoon of lemon pepper, but I'll be real honest with you, I love lemon pepper.
Me too.
So.
Especially on chicken wings.
I like double that. A teaspoon of cayenne pepper, a teaspoon of garlic powder, and one full packet of ranch seasoning. And then we're also going to add...
Are we allowed to show Hidden Valley?
Got to turn it on. Nope, we're using Hidden Valley Original Ranch. Not the low-fat or
and this,
whatever.
I actually got, I do believe, Sam's Club in a 4-pack, which you used to just get the singles. So you can buy a box now, and it comes with 4 of them. A little bit funny saver there.
Now, the recipe actually does call for 3/4 cup of vegetable oil. I used, the first time I wanted to make it, I did not have any vegetable oil, and I said, I wonder if I can use extra virgin olive oil.
EVOO!
And so I did, and I thought it was really good. Then the next time I tried vegetable oil, I didn't like it as much, to be honest.
It is a big taste difference. It really is.
And actually, at a party once, I made a bag with vegetable oil and a bag with EVOO, and I didn't tell anybody which bag was which. I just kind of quietly marked the bags. And the ones with the EVOO disappeared, and the vegetable oil ones did not get, like, really touched. So, I recommend extra virgin olive oil if you have it. If you really want to use vegetable oil, you can, but you're wrong. Just use
You just called our audience wrong.
You're so wrong.
This EVOO, you want to make sure you get a hold of it before Popeye does.
Yeah.
Because then it won't be.
Well, I don't.
Virgin.
I don't think he had an extra virgin olive oil. He just had olive oil.
Before Bluto, or I don't know.
Anyhow.
All right, so let's start this thing.
We have a gallon Ziploc bag, which happens...
Freezer bag, so it's a little heavier.
Happens to work perfect for one 16-ounce bag of the pretzels.
So would you like me to pour those in first?
Yes, please.
Okay. I always have her make these for me, so I have never actually been part of this process. So I am learning right along with you, our viewers.
I just pour the bag right in there.
I'm going to, so we're going to get salt and all. Yeah. The little twist that she was talking about earlier is I started using sourdough pretzels.
The big sourdough pretzels.
Couldn't get my hands on those today, but you will see those here in a little bit with the magic of television. These things are going to grow.
So as you've seen that we've added the whole bag to this bag, and it still gives ample space to shake it up. Now I've tried it a couple different ways. I've tried it with the oil first, but I'm going to tell you, I think it's always better if we do the dry ingredients first, because then that'll kind of sift its way through the pretzels, so when we add this, it doesn't just get all wet and clumpy at the top. So I always start with our ranch packet, and you want to do the whole thing. So pretty simple. Open up your ranch packet.
I will hold the gallon freezer baggie open for you.
Now, I don't know if you guys can tell behind our seasonings. Right now, I'm making this.
Do I want to shake this down?
Yeah, because we want it kind of mixed up in the back. Right now, I've got this sitting in a tin. At home, I don't normally use the tin. But these bags, I don't care how sturdy they are, you will always get a little bit of leakage from the olive oil until it's all settled into the pretzels.
Nobody likes leakage.
Nobody likes leakage.
Nobody. Okay, so I've coated these.
Yep. And then, it doesn't matter what order we add in our seasonings, but we've got 1 teaspoon of garlic powder. I'm going to add that in. And then 1 teaspoon of cayenne pepper.
Cayenne, ooh-wee! And what she was talking about, or we were talking about, with the longer it sits, a lot of that is with the cayenne. So it's going to build heat. Mm-hmm. And I don't mean heat like you're going to put it burn like you went to some crazy Mexican restaurant that had, you know, the Scoville.
Yeah.
It's not going to be that kind of heat.
No.
But they will get that better flavor the longer it sits.
They just get a little bit of a nicer bite. And part of that, too, is because the olive oil is now getting fully soaked into the pretzels. So it's not as... So it's allowing the seasoning to stick to the pretzels a lot better.
And like I said, she's always made these for me. And here, Dad, here's a bag of pretzels. I've never been part of the process. And when she told me how much EVOO was going in this, I'm like, really? That much? And she's like, yeah, but that's all going to absorb in there. Mm-hmm. Hence the reason why it needs to sit longer.
Yep. And it'll look like a lot. I'll show you. But so now I'm adding my almost 2.5 teaspoons of lemon pepper, because this stuff is... and of itself, like crack. I love it.
We both love it.
So in that goes. And then just give all those seasonings a nice little mix in the bag.
Zip it again. That's what my wife tells me all the time. Zip it.
Zip it.
No, just zip it.
Especially when he whistles.
She loves my whistles.
All right.
I wish we could have got the close-up on that one. Of this powder. I don't know if you can see that of the seasoning. It's amazing.
It's just so kind of all mixed
now
together.
She is going to add
3/4 cup of EVOO. I'm gonna do this right over the bag.
I greatly appreciate that. God, that smells so good already. It's insane how good that smells. And really what I'm picking up on is the lemon.
Mm-hmm.
Alright. Okay. Just let it drip. Drip, 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 drip.
I'm just going to set this down in here.
Okay. I'm going to zip. And I'm going to get a lot of the air out without crunching the pretzels.
Now, I want to show here, see if we can hold up this bag, and I don't know if you can see in here, I'm going to do a small close-up here, I don't know if you can see in here, but there is a good amount of oil just hanging at the bottom there.
And just hanging out. It's just hanging out.
So that is when I normally will take the bag and I will try and, see, this is why we get this.
And so why do we put all this in here?
Yep. So, at this point, I normally try and grab the bottom of the bag here, and I get it so that it's going to just dump all this down onto the pretzels. Mm-hmm. And then I'd start doing one of these kind of shakes. Flip it.
She's shaking it up.
And I want to get it a good shake. This is honestly my favorite part.
It's her husband's favorite part too. Okay, yeah, I can feel that kind of.
That's what?
Yeah, I know.
So, anyhow, once, sometimes you just gotta like let it sit like this for a minute so it all drips down. And then as we see it drip down, we flip it and we do it again. But you'll give this several good mixes. And then once you've given it a really good shake, right now it's not super adequate right now, but we'll get to it later. We're not going to sit here and shake for 20 minutes. But and you don't have to shake for 20 minutes by any means. But then I will set it down on its side like this, typically, and I'll let it sit. And once it's sat for... Now, granted, I say for like an hour, but once it's sat for any given amount of time, just every once in a while, go over there, give it a good shake, flip it over, and let it all settle back down.
What I found is when she's made these for me, I mean, like, I'll be in here doing whatever, and she makes them up. She goes, "All right, Dad, the pretzels are on the counter." So, again, letting them go for 3-4 days, I got... Excuse me, lemon pepper. I knew I could feel it. I could feel it coming. It usually comes in threes, so bear with me. But putting in this foil pan, and then for the next 3-4 days, I walk past it. I'm going to take it, and I'm going to flip it. And I get home from work, or before I leave for work, I'm going to shake it, and I'm going to flip it. And it's just back and forth, and back and forth, and back and forth. And as those pretzels start to absorb that olive oil with all those yummy seasonings, patience will pay off if you wait 3 to 4 days.
And here in just a moment, with the magic of television, I'm gonna show you what the bag's gonna look like when you know the pretzels are done. Cause you'll be able to tell the bag's gonna look a lot less wet, like you got just all this liquid coming down already. I give it a good shake. It's going to look a lot less wet, and it's going to look like there's just dry, clumped up powder everywhere. And that's how you know that these pretzels are about ready to go. They're looking good. So I think we need a little help from Wayne and Garth.
Hit it, Wayne.
All right, Garth.
So there you go. After the magic of television, here is the finished result, actually. Mariah made these last week, so they've been sitting for a week, which is what you want to do, again, 3-4 days. But as she said, what, an hour or so?
What? Oh, yeah, the recipe says wait at least 1 to 2 hours.
I would at least wait a day. If yeah, you're going to have the, you know, Sunday fun day party, I make them on Saturday. If you're doing a Saturday college football thing, I make them Friday. I definitely.
But if you've got the time, try and make them at least 3 to 4 days ahead of time. So what we were kind of talking about before, you can see.
She's using the jumbo bag.
I did use the jumbo bag just because I feel when I'm using the bigger pretzels, it's easier if I've got more room than just, yeah. So you can kind of tell with the bag, it's less wet, but the bag looks dirty. It kind of looks like I don't want to put my hand in there, but I'm telling you what.
I'm going to put my hand in there.
Put my hand in there. These are so good.
This sucker right here.
Let's get a little zoom. See, it's nicely soaked up and it's evenly coated there. Looks delicious.
Fantastic, everybody. Great snack. Shouldn't talk with my mouth full. Great snack. Keep in the bag, make a couple bags, set them around the different tables, and they will disappear, and they go really good with beer. Very good with beer.
Yeah, I took these on vacation 1 year, and I made a bag, and one night we killed them. So I went to the grocery, I got the stuff, I made another bag, the next night we killed those. So we ended up making 3 bags of these on a 5-day vacation because we just couldn't stop eating them. They were so good.
Yep, I can totally understand that. All right, guys, give it a try. trust us. And we'd really appreciate feedback. You try our recipes, comment below. Let us know how it worked out for you and what you thought. Mm-hmm. And also, as she mentioned last week, you guys got ideas, something we can implement here on Crockpot Crack, let us know. Instant message, however, and we'll give it a try. We'll put it right here on this segment. So until next time, this has been
Crockpot Crack without the Crockpot.